Good morning, student. How are you today? How are you feeling today?
Good morning, teacher. Very well.
Hola, Alejandra. Fine, 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 fine. Okay, guys. Today we're not talking about for the sea animals. Okay. The objective for this class is to promote the dialogue among the students, spread their opinion about the ocean animal deep life. Okay.
Okay.
It's very important today with the express and the sentence are working to the present simple and continue and the past simple and continue. For example, Caroline, what is this day? Ellos trabajan duro.
Present.
Yes. It's a present simple continue.
Simple continue.
Uh-huh. Ellos trabajan duro, muy duro. Ellos están trabajando muy duro. ¿Cómo sería?
He is.
Ellos.
¿A ellos? Ellos, they are. Working.
Yes.
Duro, no sé cómo se dice.
Very, very hard. Yes. Very hard.
Yes.
Duro.
Very hard. Okay. Very good. Okay. This is you apply the present continue. Okay. Pay attention. Okay. Alejandra, ellos estaban jugando en el parque.
Ellos estaban. They were.
Yes.
They were play in the park.
Remember, E and G. Always you use the wasn't were and
the,
yes.
Okay.
Yes.
They
again.
Were playing in the park.
Yes. Very good. Caroline. Él hizo la tarea.
He did the homework.
Podría ser. Sí, maybe. Él hizo la tarea. Ojo que estamos hablando de simple. Él hizo la tarea. The past simple. Caroline, ¿qué le pasó? Bueno, démosle una espera a Caroline. Bueno, él hizo la tarea, Alejandra. Mientras Caroline
entra otra vez. ¿Él hizo la tarea? He did the homework.
Remember, the past simple. Necessary, you the additional the auxiliar, ¿no? Tú puedes hacer el pasado simple así como hacemos el presente simple. Solamente le colocas el verbo en pasado. Entonces, ¿y qué? Pasado de make. Bueno, voy a dar una pista. Pasado de
make.
Ajá. Entonces, ¿cómo
he
sería?
Made the homework.
Yes. The homework o task, ¿no? He made the task. Porque task también significa tarea.
That's,
acuérdate de los sinónimos. Ajá, ok. Yeah, you are this the most clear for the you. Ahí está Caroline. Ok. For the most clear for the you answer the question for the in past simple, upon on simple present, the different times. Caroline, you hear me?
Yes.
Ok. Bueno, yes. ¿Dónde quedamos? ¿Cómo es que se dice? Él hizo la tarea.
Eso es presente simple, pasado simple, ¿cierto?
No, pasado simple. Sí, señora.
Entonces, he did, que es el pasado,
pasado simple. Ojo que es make, ¿no? Porque estamos haciendo de que la hace.
Ah,
¿no?
Hacer la tarea. Bueno, hizo también.
Sí.
Ah. Make.
Ajá. ¿Y cuál es el pasado de make?
Made.
Made, ajá.
They made
The homework.
The homework or task. Okay. Give me another example. Dame otro ejemplo de presente, de pasado simple.
She went to the cinema.
Okay, she went to cinema. Very good. Thank you, Caroline. Alejandra, give me another sample de presente de pasado continuo.
Pero ya el de trabajo. He was running in the park.
Yes, very good, Caroline. An example for the past continue.
Lola was not working yesterday.
Ah, very good, very good. And the present continue, Caroline?
Yes. ¿Cómo sí, presente?
Ajá. Me toca presente, a mí.
Continuo.
Ah, presente. ¿Quién? ¿Caroline?
Sí.
Okay. ¿Otro ejemplo?
Sí, de presente continuo.
I'm working in the park.
I'm working.
No. Me falta el verbo to be.
Acuérdate que sí. I am working in the shopping center, ¿no? Yo podría estar trabajando en el centro comercial. Normally, in the table, the restaurant of the place, the eat place, in the shopping center, en la plaza de comidas. Que hay wifi gratis. The free wifi. Okay, the another, Caroline, otro ejemplo.
Otro ejemplo. She's walking on the mountain.
Yes, very good. Ana Alejandra, thank you. Alejandra, ejemplo en presente.
En presente, I am studying English.
Very good. And the present simple?
I study English.
Yes. Study English. And Caroline, the present simple?
Present simple, Oscar rides a bicycle or bike. Es montar bicicleta.
Oscar, ¿cómo es que es? Oscar.
Rides.
Ajá, bikes.
Bike.
The bike, okay. The yes, very good. Okay, for the most clear, when do you practice the these times, the verbs? O sea, es mucho más fácil cuando ustedes practican así, entenderlo de las respuestas y las cosas que tienen que hacer cuando colocamos las preguntas.
Yes, teacher.
Eso es lo que ustedes deben practice another times with the different situations and center, but it always you are present the structure for the answer, the questions. Okay, this is okay, a teacher. Little exercise. Okay, guys, beginning. What's the animal? Oh, pero les voy a hacer una preguntita por aquí para que lo tenga más clarito. Give me a second.
Hola, teacher.
Hola. ¿Quién me habla? ¿Quién me habla?
Espérame, madre, se volvió loco. Ya va. Aquí está la profe, habla de Julián.
¿Profe?
¿Te está llamando Julián? Sí, Julián. ¿Dónde estás? ¿Qué no te veo? Bien. Tell me. I miss you. Te estamos extrañando. Añádete a la donde está el iconito verde arriba en la llamada para que te puedas integrar.
Profe, pero es que no tengo la internet en mi computador. Se cayó la internet.
Porque está arreglando el internet. ¿Dónde estás? ¿Estás en dónde? Pero no tienes internet en el celular, porque lo puedes hacer a través del celular, Julian.
Bueno, ya.
Julian, ¿qué?
Sí, pero ya me voy a...
Te puedes conectar a través del celular, Julian.
¿Cómo le han pedido llamar al número?
No, entras al Skype común y corriente y ya te unes a la llamada.
Pero tengo un problema que yo no me puedo contactarme al Skype porque el internet en mi computador se me cayó.
No tienes cómo llegar rapidito un café internet por ahí. ¿Con qué?
¿Aló?
Sí, Julian, te escucho. ¿No puedes llegar rapidito un café internet? Y te damos espera mientras vamos empezando.
¿Profe?
Si puedes entrar en
un café internet que tengo por ahí. Sí, dile, porque no creo que me escuche bien, Caroline, please.
Sí, ya.
Listo. Entonces ahí te estamos esperando.
Sí, dile que apenas llegue el café internet que estamos ahí, que se agregue, que ahí está el grupo, entonces que se ingrese y que por ahorita... Entonces nosotras seguimos mientras él llega, ¿vale? Entonces seguimos, que yo ahorita le explico a él nuevamente, ¿vale?
Ya colgó y dijo que iba a mirar a ver si podía ir a un café internet, que se le había caído el internet.
Ok, en la casa, bueno. O... Sí, no te digo que esta semana anda loco el internet.
Sí.
It's a crazy the connectivity. Ok, guys. Ok. For this, one question. Which animal of the ocean do you like the most? Justify your answer. ¿Qué animal del océano les gusta más? Justifiquen su respuesta. Entonces les voy a dar 3 minutes for the
¿del océano, teacher?
This question. Yes, the ocean. Okay.
Hay un pequeño inconveniente.
¿Y qué es?
En todo el barrio no hay internet. Pero el sistema en todo el barrio, entonces yo no me puedo comunicar. Y tampoco podré ir al café internet porque están arreglándolo.
Ok, Julian.
Pero no tienes
datos. Don't worry, no te preocupes. No, es que le comen mucho dato.
¿Para cuándo quedaría la clase entonces?
El martes, ¿cierto?
Sí, el próximo martes.
Hola.
El próximo martes nos vemos, Julián.
Bueno, entonces el próximo martes.
Bueno.
Ok.
Besis.
Sí, listo. Ahí te está escuchando.
No, don't worry, don't worry.
Bueno, thank you.
Bueno, bye.
Okay, bye.
Bye, Besis, Julián. Oh, my God. That's a really problem. And the Colombian country. That's a normal, no? That's a normal problem.
Yes, teacher.
No, but it's very bad. The connectivity, the internet, the operators. I don't know. Okay. Okay, gonna finish.
One moment, please.
Okay.
Hola, profe, ¿cómo estás?
Ay, hello.
Hello, teacher. Es que hubo problemas.
No, don't worry. It's a normal today. Okay, Julian. Until your classmate, mientras tus compañeras terminan de responder una pregunta, te voy a poner al tanto de lo que hay hoy. Bueno, hoy, we're talking about that the ocean animals, ¿no? Los animales del océano. Entonces, habíamos hecho una práctica con Caroline and Alejandra about the sentence, the past simple and past progressive, and the past simple and progressive, present simple and progressive. Okay. Entonces, yo les hice una preguntita. ¿Cómo se dice, ellos están trabajando duro?
They are working.
Tell me.
They are working.
Ajá.
A worker, aunque no sé cómo se dirá duro, pero.
Very hard.
Yes.
Ok, entonces, ¿cómo quedaría, Julian?
They work it.
They are working. Ajá, hard.
Very hard. Duro en inglés.
Duro very en hard.
Very hard?
Yes.
They are working. Okay.
They are working very hard, ¿no? Ellos trabajan muy duro. Dame un ejemplo, dame otro ejemplo de presente continuo.
A ver. Other example. She She is playing.
Oh, ojo que estamos hablando de presente simple. I remember you addition an ing the bear, ¿no?
Okay.
Okay. Otra vez, again.
Sí, a ver, presente simple.
Progresivo.
Ah, presente progresivo. Uh-huh. Sí. Presente progresivo no es en ED, ¿cierto?
No, ese es el pasado. Ese, acuérdate que es el pasado.
Presente
pasado simple.
Ajá.
Como la oración que hicimos ahorita, Julian.
Ajá. Sí. No, es player, no.
Ella, entonces puedes decir que ella está jugando. ¿Cómo digo? Ella está jugando en donde.
She is.
I remember.
Play.
That's singular. Singular.
Uh-huh.
No, she, wait, no.
No, she's playing. No.
I remember the structure. I remember your structure, the plus progressive, the simple, the past, the present progressive.
Uh-huh.
Is auxiliar, the pronoun, more auxiliar, more verb, more ing, more complement. Okay. I remember? Okay. Ya la pues. ¿Cómo?
She is.
más el verbo. ¿Qué verbo puedes utilizar? ¿Ah? Te voy a dar un ejemplo. She is buying a new car. Ella está comprando un nuevo carro. ¿Ya? Entonces ahí está lo que yo te acabo de explicar, la estructura. Ahorita. Así, dame un ejemplo.
She is playing.
ENG. She's playing.
She's playing.
Estoy escuchando algo ahí.
¿Era que cortaba la llamada? ¿Qué?
No. Ahora otra vez sí. Dime otra vez. ¿She qué? ¿She playing qué?
She playing.
Ajá.
To the park.
Ajá.
Into the park at afternoon. Oh, correcto.
Podría ser.
Ah, okay.
Podría ser, sí. Sería, ella está jugando en el parque, ¿no?
Por la tarde.
Pues no estaría definido, entonces no podría ser así. Entonces, podría ser ejemplo. Otro ejemplo. Ella está jugando with the dog, con el perro. ¿Ya? Ajá. Ella está jugando con el perro. Listo, ya, nomás. Dame otro ejemplo.
¿Pero de playing o otro verbo, profe?
No, otro verbo, utiliza otro verbo.
She drank it.
¿Quién es el blanco?
She drank her soda.
Ojo que tiene que llevar el ING. Recuerda la estructura. Que practique la estructura. ¿Qué verbo es ese que me estás diciendo?
She drinking. Ella toma. Ella tomó.
Ah, drinking, ok, ya. She is drinking what?
She is drinking soda.
Soda, very good. En past simple, dame una oración en past simple, ¿cómo sería?
She is drinking soda, la soda.
En pasado simple, recuerda que ahí sí utilizas el ED, ¿te acuerdas? Si es regular o si es irregular, pues ya utilizas la otra estructura que hemos hablado en otras clases pasadas. Entonces, ¿cómo sería? Por ejemplo, vamos a hacer un ejemplo. Ella hizo la tarea. She made the task, ¿no?
Ok.
De sí.
Hola, Caroline.
Entonces, dame una.
Ok. Entonces, she drink it. Drinking.
No. Drinking nothing.
Uh-huh. She is.
No, she is porque estamos hablando del pasado.
No.
I remember. She... You they change the verb. Acuérdate que cambia solo el verbo. Y estamos hablando de pasado.
She play. No.
Play it. She play it.
She play it.
Ajá, pero ¿qué? Complemento.
She played tennis in a gym.
In the gym yesterday, ¿no?
Yes.
Entonces, ¿cómo quedaría? Vuélveme a decir otra vez.
She played tennis.
Ajá.
To a gym yesterday.
Yes. These are more simple in the past simple. Okay, con pasado continuo. Dame una con pasado continuo.
Pasado simple, pasado.
I remember the was and were, the singular and plural, more, man, and the verb ing mark complement. I remember. For example, ella estuvo comiendo pizza ayer. She was eating a pizza yesterday. Okay? For this example. Another example. Okay? Dame otro.
Sí. She was to studying in the hospital. Allá estuvo. En...
¿Que estaba estudiando en el hospital?
Ella estuvo. Staying.
Ah. Ojo. Ojo que ahí es staying. Ella visited. ¿No sería mejor?
Ay,
visiting the hospital. Yes. Y according is for the sentence. Ok. Dame okay. Otro ejemplo. Para ver si ya te quedó clarito.
Otro ejemplo. A ver.
Yes.
He was.
Ajá.
He was studying to the university.
To was study yesterday, colócale ahí. To study the yesterday. Pero más o menos ya cogiste, ¿cierto, Julian? ¿Ya entendiste cómo es?
Yes, yes miss. Yes.
So. Okay, okay. Bueno. Okay, Julian, please. Tell me you the answer the question. Which the animal, the ocean, do you like the most? Justify your answer. Te estoy diciendo que qué animal del océano te gusta más y justifica tu respuesta. Te voy a dar 3 minutos mientras entonces sigo hablando con Caroline y con Alejandra, ¿vale? Mientras tú vas buscando qué animal te gusta más y por qué te gusta. Okay. Recuerda las estructuras de ejercicio que hicimos ahorita para que me contestes así, ¿vale?
¿Es de la guía de la que me enviaste?
Sí, esa preguntita que hay allí.
What is special about octopus?
No, estamos abajo. Baja porque ahí estás arriba. Estamos acá abajo. Después donde dice speaking, Terry. Baja, baja. Dice speaking minute 13. Ahí ya estamos. De la pregunta.
The magician of the sea.
Estamos abajo.
Que otra guía. No creo que sea esa.
No, dale ahí que ahí abajito está. Dice llamada iniciada abajo. You can hear me. Y abajo dice, which the animal, the ocean, to do like it the most, justify your answer. ¿Ya lo encontraste?
No, no,
¿qué animal del océano te gusta más? Y justifica tu respuesta. Esa es la pregunta. Apúntala ahí. ¿Qué animal del océano te gusta más? Y justifica tu respuesta. Okay. Bueno, Caroline, tell me a talking about for the which the ocean do you like the most, please?
I like the whales, and the dolphins.
Whale, okay.
Because they are smart, and why dolphin makes acrobatics or pirouettes, and also because whales are modern will take. Good care of the junk o crías o algo así. Es que no sé bien cómo se cría. Si es junk o...
¿De young mammals? Vamos a...
Yes.
A ver, ¿cómo son? ¿Crías de qué? ¿Pero de ballena?
Sí.
Okay. Alejandra, thank you, Caroline. Baby whales. Yeah. Baby whales. Son crías de ballenas. Ya. Yeah. Voy a escribir por aquí, por el chat. Es así. Baby whale. Okay. Baby whales. Son como crías de ballenas o los bebés de las ballenas. Okay, Alejandra, tell me, talking about with the animal of the ocean, do you like the most?
The animal that I like the most is the dolphin because this animal is very intelligent, beautiful, tender, and submise. Submise.
Okay. Submise, what does that mean, the submise?
No, es como sumisos, como que se dejan coger, se dejan acariciar.
Yes, humble. What? But it's my most idea for the humble, humildes, oh, so cute. Que son como humildes o como muy lindos, pues.
Producen sí, como sumisos, que cute. Se dejan coger, que no son esquivos.
Como okay, very docile.
Okay.
With the woman.
On very dust.
Okay. Okay, don't worry. Julian, you... Julian, what is the animal of the ocean do you like the most? ¿Encontraste cuál es el animal que te gusta más del océano?
No, no lo encontré. No sé si estaba en la guía. Me la encontré.
¿Estás en dónde?
No, no lo he visto.
No, no podía encontrar. Te voy a mandar la carita.
Mándala.
Para que... Listo. Give me a second. Ahí. Está arriba la pregunta. Ya la vas a encontrar ahí. ¿La viste?
Sí, ya escuché la cara.
Eso, eso.
Which animal ahí. Of the ocean do you like the most? Just if it transfer.
Ajá, yes.
Según
lo que has escuchado, compañeras, ¿qué animal te gusta? My favorite animal, the ocean,
my is... animal of the ocean is shark.
Shark, oh, so dangerous. No, no, yes. Why? Why don't I like a shark?
The shark is the animal life in the ocean. Yes. The sharks pulls the
stronger,
water.
No? Stronger in the sea. Yes, it's stronger and sometimes it's very dangerous.
Okay, so yes.
Yeah, okay, guys. Okay, guys, you in this moment, you about the Lee, about the presentation of Prezi about the ocean animal. Pay attention, please, about this presentation. It's the only information for you. Ok, se los voy a colocar aquí, pero lo vamos a escuchar a través de mi computador, ¿ok? Okay. Entonces estemos pendientes. Yo les voy a subir acá. Listo. Give me a second, please. Give me a second. Ok.
Teacher?
Yes? Kemi?
No, es que no se escucha nada.
No, no se oye.
No, teacher.
¿Que no se escucha nada? ¿Qué es lo que escuchan ahí?
No, no, teacher. Solo nos vemos entre nosotros. No, yo solo veo a mis compañeros y no escucho nada.
Ah, ya sé qué fue lo que pasó. Give me a second.
La profe no lo puso a reproducir.
Okay, so for example. Okay, give me a second. Yes.
You hear me? Yes, ahora sí. What types of animals live in the ocean? Mammals such as dolphins and whales live in the ocean. Fish. Sharks and stingrays are a part of the fish family. Reptiles such as snakes and turtles live in the ocean. Members of the insect family. The invertebrates of the ocean are related to insects. Mollusks are the largest group of animals in the ocean. Snails, slugs, octopi, and squids are among them. Many mollusks have shells made of calcium to protect them. Sponges, sea anemones, corals, and jellyfish. These animals lack a fluid-filled cavity called the coelom. Crustaceans. Crustaceans are composed of hard exoskeletons and have paired legs. All animals have their own specific needs to survive. Since the ocean is extremely deep, environmental factors change from the surface to the bottom of the ocean. These factors include temperature and availability of water. From the surface of the ocean to the bottom of the ocean, there are three distinct layers based on their environmental factors. They are called zones. Summit of the ocean. There are three main ocean zones: the summit zone, the twilight zone, and the midnight zone. The types of mammals, fish, reptiles, and invertebrates that we have discussed all live in the top two zones of the ocean: the summit zone and the twilight zone. The summit zone is the top part of the ocean. It receives the most sunlight. This zone goes from the surface to about 200 meters underwater. Even though this is the smallest zone in the ocean, it actually supports about 90% of all marine life, such as dolphins, whales, and sea turtles. The twilight zone is below the summit zone, extending from 200 meters to 1,000 meters. Less sunlight leads to entering the twilight zone. Many animals migrate to the twilight zone and the summit zone in search of food. Examples: crustaceans and viper fish. The midnight zone is below the twilight zone, extending from about 1,000 meters down. The depth of the ocean averages around no length of country, and waters can reach close to freezing temperatures. Scientists are constantly discovering new forms of marine life, even in the deepest part of the ocean. Most animals in the midnight zone are blind or have very large eyes to allow light to pass through. Many animals in the zone are also bioluminescent, which means they can emit light through special biological processes. Let's explore the midnight zone further and learn about the ABCs of the animals that live there. Try not to be frightened. Some of these creatures can look scary. A is for apple anemone. B is for brittle star. C is for cat shark. D is for dinner plate jelly. E is for eel. F is for fangtooth. G is for giant red meisen. H is for hatchetfish. I is for icefish. J is for Johnson's sea cucumber. K is for krill. L is for lanternfish. M is for mushroom soft coral. M is for paddlefish. O is for octopus. P is for Pacific hagfish. Q is for queen triggerfish. R is for ray. S is for sea dragon. T is for tadpole snailfish. U is for umbrella snail. V is for vampire squid. W is for wolffish. X is for x-ray fish. Y is for yellow moray eel. Z is for zooplankton. Ocean Animals by Aaron. Ocean Animals.
Okay, guys. I really like this video, the presentation.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
You were about the ocean. What are you talking about for this presentation? What is the animal you know, que ustedes conocían? Y what animals know, que no conocían?
The animals.
Anguila, okay.
Fish.
What else? Fish, yes.
I know the dolphin, shark,
the star,
tortoises, tortugas.
Yes, turtle.
Turtle, okay.
The turtle, yes. Yes, a turtle, no? The different animals. If you pay attention for the in this presentation, you and the find the animals, the ocean mammal animals, then the old alphabet, the letter alphabet, the A or the C.
Yes.
Que animales desde A, Zeta,
I love
the
animals.
All the ocean. Yes, I love the animals. Okay. What is the word you like this? This is presentation. Yes, that's the most the ocean animal you like. Of this presentation. ¿Qué animal les gustó más de esta presentación?
The turtles.
Okay, another animal. I'll say the name, no? Johnson, sea cucumber. Ese animal, ese pepino, que parecía un pepino, que se llamaba Johnson, pepino de mar. You like, you see? You can see the presentation? No?
I don't like, yes.
It's a very... The four fins is very strange. Okay, the another is the octopus. No, the octopus is very big. The octopus in the ocean. And another animal I don't know is that yellow moray. Never is say that they call the fish. I don't know. There's a yellow moray. This is very strange fish. It's a very ugly. It's a very ugly. Page. Okay, guys. In this moment, you this a practice with the video about the octopus. Okay. Entonces, pay attention, please. There's a video. Here are the comments about this. Is I really like this video because it's a good pronunciation and explain. From the draft and the video, okay? Entonces, se los voy a mandar. Por favor, close the microphone, pay attention and take a note about the most important for you in this video, okay?
Okay, teacher.
Okay, les voy a mandar el link para que cada uno lo escuche. Por favor, cierran los micrófonos para que lo vean allá. Ya se los envié. Me cuentan a ver si lo pueden abrir, ¿vale?
Yes, teacher, I can.
Okay, I can, okay. When you finish the activity, please let me know. Déjenmelo saber, ¿no? Cuando termine la actividad, por favor, me lo dejan saber, ¿vale?
Okay, teacher.
What could... What could octopuses possibly have in common with us? After all, they don't have lungs, spines, or even a plural noun we can all agree on. But what they do have is the ability to solve puzzles, learn through observation, and even use tools, just like some other animals we know. And what makes octopus intelligence so amazing is that it comes from a biological structure completely different from ours. The 200 or so species of octopuses are mollusks belonging to the order Cephalopoda, Greek for head feet. Those heads contain impressively large brains, with a brain-to-body ratio similar to that of other intelligent animals, and a complex nervous system with about as many neurons as that of a dog. But instead of being centralized in the brain, these 500 million neurons are spread out in a network of interconnected ganglia organized into three basic structures. The central brain only contains about 10% of the neurons, while the two huge optic lobes contain about 30%. The other 60% are in the tentacles, which for humans would be like our arms having minds of their own. This is where things get even more interesting. Vertebrates like us have a rigid skeleton to support our bodies, with joints that allow us to move. But not all types of movement are allowed. You can't bend your knee backwards or bend your forearm in the middle, for example. Cephalopods, on the other hand, have no bones at all, allowing them to bend their limbs at any point and in any direction. So shaping their tentacles into any one of the virtually limitless number of possible arrangements is unlike anything we're used to. Consider a simple task, like grabbing and eating an apple. The human brain contains a neurological map of our body. When you see the apple, your brain's motor center activates the appropriate muscles, allowing you to reach out with your arm, grab it with your hand, bend your elbow joint, and bring it to your mouth. For an octopus, the process is quite different. Rather than a body map, the cephalopod brain has a behavior library. So when an octopus sees food, its brain doesn't activate a specific body part, but rather a behavioral response to grab. As the signal travels through the network, the arm neurons pick up the message and jump into action to command the movement. As soon as the arm touches the food, a muscle activation wave travels all the way through the arm to its base, while the arm sends back another wave from the base to the tip. The signals meet halfway between the food and the base of the arm, letting it know to bend at that spot. What all this means is that each of an octopus's 8 arms can essentially think for itself. This gives it amazing flexibility and creativity when facing a new situation or problem. Whether it's opening a bottle to reach food, escaping through a maze, moving around in a new environment, changing the texture and the color of its skin to blend into the scenery, or even mimicking other creatures to scare away enemies. Cephalopods may have evolved complex brains long before our vertebrate relatives, and octopus intelligence isn't just useful for octopuses. Their radically different nervous system and autonomously thinking appendages have inspired new research in developing flexible robots made of soft materials. And studying how intelligence can arise along such a divergent evolutionary path can help us understand more about intelligence and consciousness in general. Who knows what other forms of intelligent life are possible, or how they process the world around them.
In his teacher.
Okay. Finalizando, bien, ver. I remember the washed and the pants simple in the finish. Okay, so wash it. I finished the watch the video. Okay, you are. I don't additional ed. ¿Qué significa ed? Ado, oído, ¿no? Entonces dice ahí finalizado. Haber visto el video. Dice más o menos eso. Ok, entonces tú le dices aquí, finish or the watch the video, no more. Ok, entonces, okay. I finish the watch the video y ya. Ahí okay. Estás diciendo, ya finalicé el video. Entonces, I remember only you the use ed or irregular verbs when the you the time is in the past, ¿no? Cuando lo utilices en pasado, ¿ya? Entonces, okay. De esa manera tú ya te vas como ubicando. Listo, Caroline. You hear me? You can hear me?
Yes, teacher, can you hear me?
Okay. Okay, guys. You are the talking about the video for the octopus brain. Julian, we're not talking about first the video. ¿Qué te gustó más? What is the most like?
The video is a purple. Go to the coffee. Go to the open the coffee. The
where the most like the video about the octopus brain. ¿Qué fue lo que más te gustó el video?
In the video, he liked it, the purple go to wash it, the cover it. The purple is open the cover.
Open the compressor for the beat box. Okay.
Okay. See, yes.
Okay. Thank you for sharing your comments, Julia. Please, Caroline. Thanks. You are talking about the octopus brain.
They learn more about this animal because the octopus learns from observation.
Yes.
So the octopus is smart.
Yes.
Also, they have not bones. Huesos.
Yes. Okay.
They can be camouflaged. Did I just say camouflage? Is camouflage?
Yes. The mimetics. Yes.
Y ahí finish. Es lo que más me parece más interesante.
Okay. I really like. Okay. Thank you for your sharing with your opinion. Okay, Alejandra, what are you talking about for this video?
I like the video that the octopus is very smart because he shared. Él busca la forma. He shared the shark, the shape.
The way.
Okay. Hun eats prey, and he had a arc, and the difference with the humans.
Nothing more. Okay. For this, it's a bit so it's interesting because the octopus is very, very intelligent, and the another information is that 200 species the octopus, no, for the type. The another is the Schengen, the texture, and mimetism. Everybody use a complex verbal system, no? For this video, I say that that's the information. Okay? Okay, guys. In this moment, you are talking about the comprehension, the reading about this read. Imagine of the sea of the sea. Okay, give me a second. Me dicen si lo pueden descargar. Este Google. Okay, hay de reading. Okay, me dicen si lo pueden descargar. Y si no, entonces para mandarles el físico. Okay.
Ya lo abrí.
¿Ya lo abrí? Okay. Please close your microphone, please. Aquí logran ver. Can you see a screen?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Yes. And this. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Okay. These are reading comprehension. Okay. For the first part, Julian, please read the first part about the read. Léeme por favor. Esta primera parte, okay.
What do you three hear? Eight arms and one young brain add up to an octopus, a creature that can do aiming things. Octopuses, okay. Octopuses are extremely intelligent. They have even learned a few tricks to get them out of sticky situation, as for example, when it is afraid of the predators. As octopuses don't have teeth or sharp claws to defend themselves, they hit themselves to the sand on the bottom of the ocean floor. Do you want to know how they do what do that? With the octopus is like a chameleon because it can change the color of its skin to match the sand. This color shakes happens in less than a minute.
Okay, Caroline, please. Thank you. Julian.
Okay.
Caroline, please continue.
Vamos que en el primero o en el segundo. Me perdí la lectura aquí.
En el segundo dice, son octopuses.
Okay. Some octopus like to stay in more shallow water where they are rocks and coral because octopus are invertebrate and they can squeeze themselves into small space between the rocks to get out of range of predators. Another way an octopus can hide is by shooting in octopus use a part of its vocal system to shoot ink into the water. The ink forms a cloud that hits the octopus. It's like a magician doing a vanishing act.
Okay. Alejandra, please continue. Thank you, Caroline. Alejandra, can you hear me? Alejandra. ¿No estás ahí, Alejandra? ¿Qué pasó? ¿No se la escucha, Alejandra? Alejandra, can you hear me? No te logramos escuchar, Alejandra. Bueno, ok. If the octopus has been attacked, it cannot talk. Alejandra. I can make itself look like
teacher.
Vamos a ver qué pasa. No, no lo escuchamos. You hear me? No, no se le escucha. Bueno, entonces vamos a leer este pedacito. Ajá, ok, tell me.
If an octopus is being attacked, it can actually make itself look like a venomous sea snake. It will bury itself with the sun.
Give me a second, Julian, please. Give me a second. You hear me, Alejandra?
Yes, teacher. ¿Me escuchan?
Yes, ahorita sí.
Ahora sí.
Okay. Sí. Thank you, Julian. Okay, do us a third paragraph, please. Por favor, read the third paragraph.
Okay. If an octopus is being attacked, it can actually make... ¿Ya me escuchan?
Sí, yes.
It can actually make itself look like a venomous sea snake.
El celular. Eso. Eso.
¿Se escucha entrecortado?
Ok. No, ahí se escucha bien, pero deja el celular porque hace interferencia con el computer. Ok.
Ah, ok. It will bury itself in the sand, keeping two arms visible. It will change. It will change the color of those arms to match as he is nine. But if there's no time to hide, if
a
Ay, Dios. ¿Ahí ya?
Yes.
¿Dónde iba? ¿Dónde iba? It will change the color of those arms to match a sea snake. But if there is no time to hide, if an octopus is in trouble, it can break off one of its arms. The arm will then change colors and skirm around the whale to distract the predator while the octopus swim away to safety. Don't worry, Tom. The octopus arm will grow back. There is one king of... ¿Sigo leyendo? There is one king of octopus that has been known to use in defense. The blue ring.
Defense.
The blue rings. Ring. Octopus is. Ringed. Okay. The blue ringed octopus is thin. It could fit in the palm of your hand. Predators might think this sight makes the octopus a great snake, but they know to say stay away. The blue ray octopus is very poisonous and can kill predators much larger than it, including humans.
Including humans. Okay. You understand this, Okay, you understand the read? Okay, you pay attention for the read in this moment. What is the do the three hearts, the AR and your brain up to? An octopus created that they can do amazing things. Octopus is extremely intelligent. They have the ability to feel truth to give them of the sticky situations. As for example, when it's afraid of predators, octopus don't have the teeth and the sharp clams to defend themselves. They have themselves in the sand on the bottom of the ocean floor. Do want to know how they do that? Well, the octopus is like the chameleon, because it can change the color of the skin to match the sun. The color change happen in the less than a minute. So an octopus like to stay more slow where they are the blobs of coral. Because the octopus is invertebrates, they can see squeezy themselves into a small space between the rocks to get up of the rest of the predators. Otherwise, an octopus can hide and be shooting in. An octopus use and part is a body colored. The synod, they shoot into the water. The force and claw that the hides the octopus is like a magician doing the vanish act. If an octopus is begin attack, it can actually make itself look like a venomous the sea snake. It will bury itself in the sand. Keep two are visible. It will change the color of the dove's arm to the match of the sea snake. But it's no there the time to hide. In an octopus is a trouble. I can't breathe of the it's an arm. The arm will be tend to change the color and scare around the water to describe to the predator why the octopus swim away into safety. Don't worry, troll. The octopus arm will grow back. The account of the octopus can depend on to using in defense to blow around it. Octopus is a tiny insect find in the palm of your hand. Predators may think that it's a main lots of great snap, but they know to stay away. The blue ringers octopus is very poisonous. I can kill predator much larger than includes the human. Okay. For the practice, it's a answer the following question.
Tenemos cerca un teléfono por ahí que se escucha extraño.
Okay. What is the special about the octopus body? Second, what is the octopus intelligence? Third, what happened to the octopus of the breed of one its arm? How do you blue runs the octopus defend themselves? Okay. The first activity, primero hay que contestar estas preguntas. Second, complete the organizations include the habitats, abilities, like for the ways and defense itself. Okay, entonces ustedes aquí deben llenar una, donde cuál es el hábitat del pulpo, las habilidades, lo que les gusta, ¿sí? Y en la otra, las maneras de defenderse, que es lo que va aquí dentro de los cuadritos, ¿ya? Entonces ustedes lo pueden descargar y él se deja llenar allí en. Él les abre una de este en Word y ahí lo pueden llenar. ¿Ya? Y si no, entonces lo escribimos en el notebook, lo escribimos en el cuaderno. Question for the activity. ¿Preguntas acerca de la actividad?
¿Cómo contestas la pregunta de la primera parte, profe?
Las preguntas ustedes las contestan según qué, la lectura que acabamos de hacer, ¿no? Que ahí están todas las respuestas. Al igual. Sí, eso lo hacen en el cuaderno, pero pueden hacer ahí en el cuadro, ¿ok? Entonces ustedes contestan según la comprensión de lectura que ustedes tengan aquí, porque aquí están estadísticas, ¿no? Aquí fue lo último que leímos. Y la actividad de llenar, entonces eso también lo hacen según la lectura, ¿ok?
Listo, listo.
¿Listo? Okay. When did you finish, please, let me, me lo dejan saber. Entonces vamos a comentar entonces cómo nos va con este, ¿vale? Con este worksheet.
Cerrado.
Yes.
Get close your microphone, please. Alejandra.
Teacher.
Sí. Por hoy vamos a hacer solamente las preguntas y a ustedes les voy a dejar el organigrama para la casa como task, ¿ok? Para que hagamos entonces de ahí lo que me queda para hacer lo del examen, la preguntita que nos queda, ¿vale? Entonces les voy a dejar tarea.
Ok, teacher. O sea, respondemos las preguntas y el segundo punto de tarea.
Yes, take a point the task for the homework. Okay, teacher.
Okay, can I finish?
No, teacher.
¿Cuánto nos falta?
Una pregunta.
Wait. Okay. Let me know you finish the activity, okay? Entonces me dejan saber, ¿vale?
Okay,
sure. Okay, guys. Caroline, did you finish?
No, teacher.
No? ¿Por qué preguntabas?
No sé. Uno, porque se me perdió aquí esto.
¿Qué se te perdió? Alejandra, finish. Okay, Julian, finish. Julian. Okay, guys. Until you finish, please, I'm thinking about it for that this question. It is important to the take care of the ocean and the animals that are into for humanity. Okay? Porque es importante el océano y los animales que están para la humanidad. Que están ahí para la humanidad. Yes. Julián. I don't hear you. I cannot hear you. No puedo escucharte. You close your microphone.
Why es porque es cierto?
Yes.
Why the animals is important for the animals? The animals live in the ocean for why do you pass your past of the naturalism?
Natural. Okay, it's important for the naturaleza. Natural.
There is important.
Nature.
Okay. Important nature. They have. Your habitats.
Yeah.
Aquatic habitats. Aquatic habitats.
Yes.
And very important the existence.
Okay, it's just gonna be. Yes. No more, Julia?
No more.
Okay. Thank you for sharing your opinion, Julia. Okay, Colora, okay. We're not talking about what is important to take care of. Alejandra, what is the important to take care of the ocean and the animals that eat for the humanity?
Hello, teacher.
Okay, Caroline.
What
meaning? No, don't worry. Is that normal today? Okay.
The animals of the ocean are very important for the humans because it's these are the alimento. ¿Cómo se dice alimento, profe? Eating food. Ah, okay, sí, food. Yes, sirven de food for the humans.
Okay. Food, yes.
Food, sí, yes, teacher. Que son para, son uh-huh. importantes para la humanidad porque nos sirven de alimento, ¿sí? ¿Sí lo dije bien?
Yes.
O sea, ¿sí me hice entender?
Yes.
And because these animals son beautiful, and some very very important for the humans. Okay, yes. The natural.
Yes. For the human. Yes, for the natural. Okay. What more, Alejandra? Algo más?
No, teacher, no more.
Okay, thank you for sharing your opinion about these questions. Caroline, when I'm thinking about it for the, what is the important to take care of the ocean and the animals that are into for the humanity?
The ocean animals are important because they give us food, and they take care of the cleaning the ocean. How do you say cumplir?
It's a appointment to accomplish. Accomplish. Cumplir?
Funciones.
Complete. Yeah. Yes,
the functions, the ocean, ¿qué más? Pues eso fue lo que más.
Okay, thank you, Caroline. Okay, you finished that the question?
Yes.
¿Cuánto le falta? Yes, entonces vamos a hacer las respuestas. Respuestas de las preguntas. Ok, give me a second. ¿Dónde estamos? Okay, for the first, what is the special about the octopus body? ¿Qué es lo especial acerca del cuerpo del pulpo?
The octopus don't have teeth or shirts. The okay. Octopus are as chameleon because they can change the colors.
Okay, very good. The second, why are the octopus intelligent?
The octopus are intelligent because they have even learned a few tricks to get them out of a stake situation.
Okay, very good. The third, what happened to the octopus is a break of one of the its arms.
They are will grow back.
Ah, the book. Ah, well, it's a good, no? For a human.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Yes.
Very good.
Yes. Okay. Four. How do blue ringed the octopus defend themselves?
The octopus now to stay away.
To stay away?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, but it's very poison and they kill the predator, okay, for the stay away. Okay. Okay, guys. Julian. Oh my friend. You have all the time for the connectivity, the internet. They're very serious problems with the connectivity. Okay, yes, guys.
Sure.
I really you like the activities today.
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
You feel the more speaking in English?
Yes, teacher.
Yes.
Sí, okay. Siente que están hablando un poquito más en inglés? You understand you say, que empieza que dice, that is the advice for you. Necesito que por favor sigan practice for the structure, the past simple and past continuous, and you in front of the mirror, y sigan practicando en frente del espejo, y cómo hablan y todo, ¿ok? Para que sigamos pues en estas tres clases, reforzando eso. Okay, guys, thank you for paying attention. Thank you for sharing opinions and comments this activity. I remember, for another one, you, por favor, me envían. O sea, lo descargan y me envían, por favor, lo que quedamos pendiente de los puntos, que fue la parte 2 de la parte gráfica. Para entonces, para 5 minuticos en la próxima clase lo revisamos. ¿Les parece?
Ok, teacher. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Julian, for participate. Thank you, Alejandra, for participate today. Blessing. Bye bye.
Okay, teacher.
Okay,
bye.
Teacher.
Bye, Alejandra.
Thank you for the class. Bye bye.
Bye, Alejandra. Bye, Carolina.
Bye, Julian.
Bye.